Everyone, so getting ready to start on a larger, longer, more involved portrait drawing based on the smaller study completed previously. And you can kind of see here, I've kind of lightly got the contours kind of in there in graphite. And the way I got that in there was that I printed out my reference photo, covered the backside of that printout with graphite, placed it on my sheet of drawing paper, and then traced the contours, the marks that I wanted to get down here first. And then that transferred over to my drawing. I've got a video in my channel, I think it's called Transfer Tracing, that kind of shows and describes that process a little more in depth. If you're interested in learning about that, check out that video. But I do want to complete this drawing using red. I've got some red sanguine conte pencil. I'm also going to use some burnt sienna pan pastel. And I don't really want to mix that in with the graphite here. So this is new territory for me. I probably should have tried this out in the study, but I don't think it's probably going to work well to lay that conte pencil and pan pastel on top of this graphite. So I'm going to pull some of this graphite off of here. I'm going to erase it a little bit to where I can just still see it, but there's not a whole lot of graphite on there. That mixes in with the conte or the pan pastel, that could create some problems for me. So I don't want to do that. This also gives me the opportunity to go back in and correct all of the inaccuracies that always happen with a tracing. I mentioned this in the transfer tracing video too. You never want to rely on just the tracing. It's highly inaccurate. So I'm also going to go back over these marks and looking at my reference photo and kind of refine them and get them a little more accurate before moving on. These first stages of the drawing are going to be light. I'm going to focus on the bigger shapes and make sure I get the proportions and the sizes and the shapes in there accurately. And then I'll get into developing light and shadow, start adding tone, value to it. But that'll come later. So what I'm going to do now is kind of lighten up these graphite marks and then start to refine this tracing. So I use the kneaded eraser. The kneaded eraser is a little easier on the paper. It doesn't tear it up as much. But I still can still see the lines very well, and that's fine. I don't want to lose them, but there is still maybe a little more graphite than I'd like there to be. And I know for you all, it's very difficult to see. You probably can't see much of anything on there. So I'm going to try a different eraser. I've got a gum eraser, which is very gentle on the paper too. So I'm going to go grab that and try that out too. Here's a small chunk of my gum eraser. I like these. I saw one of the someone at Michael's, one of the employees at Michael's, using this to remove marks from a piece of mat board or something, and it worked really well. And it didn't damage the mat board, the surface of the mat board. So I bought one and tried it out. It works well. The only problem I have with it is that it's really crumbly. This is just a small part of the eraser I originally had. So it's kind of crumbly. But let's see if I can get some more of this graphite off of here.